Well, here's the uncomfortable reality. Freud was at least right about one thing, which is that the brain circuitry that you used to develop attachments to your caregivers, mother and father or other caregivers, do not disappear when you hit puberty. They are repurposed for romantic and sexual relations. And so this is why the whole notion of anxious attached and secure attached, you know, stems from childhood attachment patterns, but it carries over to romantic relationships. And of course, early experiences too, and traumatic or positive or neutral. The thing that's really important to remember though in this transfer of circuitry from one role to another is that, and it's certainly consistent with psychoanalysis, that gender is interchangeable, sex is interchangeable. So for instance, let's say you had a wonderful relationship. Let's take a hypothetical person. I'm truly not referring to myself. Let's take a young woman who has a wonderful relationship to her father and a just absolutely terrible abusive relationship to her mother, just for sake of example. She then goes into adulthood and she is drawn to very abusive men. Not always, but let's just use in this example. And the dynamic is exactly the same as the dynamic she had with her mother. That's actually a common occurrence. Even though in this context, she's heterosexual, she's romantically attracted to men, what is seen over and over again is that the dynamic with one parent can be transferred onto a romantic dynamic, but it doesn't have to be. If it was with the mother, then it only has to do with relationships to women. So gender is interchangeable because these circuitries are pre-sexual. They're laid down in our brain before the brain has any concept of sexual interactions. It's pre-pubertal. And so there are a lot of interesting examples and data to support this. The book Attached is a pretty interesting book by two psychologists. One, I think, is at Columbia University, that talks about how childhood dynamics carry over to adult romantic attachment. So as you can tell, I get pretty alert in response to these questions. I get a lot of them relate in this domain.
They have a lot of impact on people, and they're wondering about, they want to learn.
And no one knows what other people are doing or what's normal. We kind of know deviancy. We know perversion. We know the extremes.
Yeah.
We know the rules. Hopefully people know the rules. But there are a lot of people in the academic community, in particular at certain East Coast schools, not to be named, that are in open relationships. This is more common now. It's not very common, but it's more common. Obviously, that's a way of bypassing some of these more primitive emotions about jealousy, et cetera, and leveraging them towards maybe even ongoing relationships. I'm not passing judgment one way or the other. I always say four conditions have to be met for any discussion about sex and sexuality or sexual health: age appropriate, context appropriate, consensual, and species appropriate.